So here are 10 French words and expressions that don't mean what you think. Stick around. So the first expression is coup de soleil. Coup de soleil. Alright, so at the first glance, you may think this means, because coup in French means a blow or a punch. Soleil means sun. So literally it means a blow of the sun. But in actual sense, this means a sunburn. Okay? A sunburn. So coup de soleil does not mean the heat of the sun or a blow of the sun. It actually means a sunburn. So there are other examples like this, like coup de main. Coup de main. Coup de main means a hand. Okay? But the coup means a blow. So this does not mean a punch. Coup de main actually means to give a hand, to give a helping hand. Par exemple, tu peux me donner un coup de main demain matin? Tu peux me donner un coup de main demain matin? Can you give me a hand tomorrow morning? Tu peux me donner un coup de main demain matin? Can you give me a hand tomorrow morning? So, coup de main does not mean a blow. Actually means to help somebody, to give a hand. Also, you have coup d'ensoir. Coup d'ensoir. Coup d'ensoir does not mean a blow in the evening. No, it means a one-night stand. Okay? It means a one-night stand. Coup d'ensoir. You also have coup de pouce. Coup de pouce. Coup de pouce literally means a punch of the thumb. But in actual sense, it means to steer someone in the right direction. Okay, you are not helping the person, but you're just leading the person to the right direction. Coup de coup. So there are several expressions. I'm sure you're aware of coup d'état. Coup d'état. Coup d'état means a coup, state coup. So you also have coup de cœur. Coup de cœur. Coup de cœur means it doesn't mean a heart punch, but it means to suddenly fall in love with something. Okay, I think this is more commonly used with objects and not people. So maybe love at first sight, something like that for objects. For example, il a vraiment eu un coup de cœur pour ce t-shirt. Il a vraiment eu un coup de cœur pour ce t-shirt. That means he suddenly fell in love with this t-shirt. And one of my favorites is actually coup de fil. Okay, coup de fil means a phone call. Okay, par exemple, je vais te passer un coup de fil demain. Je vais te passer un coup de fil demain. I'm going to give you a call tomorrow. Or faut que tu me passes un coup de fil ce soir. Faut que tu me passes un coup de fil ce soir. Make sure you call me this evening, or make sure, or it is necessary that you actually call me this evening. Okay? Faut que tu me passes un coup de fil ce soir. Le coup de fil in French means a phone call. Alright, so the next expression is péter le feu. Péter le feu. Alright, so you know the verb péter means to fart or to burst or to explode. Why feu? Le feu means fire. So this literally means farting fire, to fart fire. But no, péter le feu is actually an expression used by older people to signify that they are still agile, they can still work, they are still acting. Okay, péter le feu. The next expression is poule mouillée. Okay, poule mouillée. So if you are not an absolute beginner, you know poule in French means hen, and you know when it's cooked, hen or chicken, but when it's cooked, it becomes le poulet. Okay, so what you're actually eating, what's on your table that you're eating, is not la poule, it's le poulet. But when it's still living, when it's alive, then it's la poule. Okay, so that's the difference between la poule and le poulet. La poule is the end of chicken when it's still alive, while le poulet is when it's cooked. Okay, when it's on your table, you're ready to eat it. So poule mouillée, literally, when you look at it at the first glance, means a wet hen. Well, actually, no. Poule mouillée actually means a coward, okay? Someone that is not brave, someone not courageous, a coward. So you could call someone poule mouillée, that means a coward. And some people also say ma poule, okay? Ma poule is a form of affection. You can call someone you're dating ma poule, meaning my love or my heartbeat, something like that. And the next expression is chauve-souris, okay? Chauve-souris. All right, if you've learned animals in French, you know that souris means a mouse, where the word chauve means bald. So literally this means a bald mouse. But no, chauve-souris actually means a bat. So the word bat in French is chauve-souris. The next expression is souris de plombier. Souris de plombier, which literally means, the souris in French means smile. Plombier means plumber, okay? Plumber. So literally this means smile of a plumber. But no, it's not what you think. Souris de plombier actually means the stripe of your underwear that is actually visible when you bend or maybe when you go down with it. So that part that people can see is called souris de plombier. So souris de plombier does not mean the smile of a plumber, okay? All right, the next expression is couvre-feu. Okay, so the word couvre, the verb couvre, all right, so the verb couvre is from the verb couvrir, which means to cover, okay? White feu means fire. So you may think this means the fire that is covered, or to cover fire, but no. Couvre-feu actually means a curfew, okay? Curfew in French is couvre-feu. Par exemple, le gouvernement nigérian a imposé un couvre-feu pour lutter contre le virus corona. Okay? Le gouvernement nigérian a imposé un couvre-feu pour lutter contre le coronavirus. Okay? So the Nigerian government imposed a curfew for the fight against coronavirus. And the next expression is main d'œuvre. Okay? Main d'œuvre. Main d'œuvre. Main d'œuvre. Alright, so this you may want to think it means handmade, but no. You know, main in French means hand, œuvre means work. Okay, so you may want to think it means hand work, but actually means manual labor. Okay, manual labor or workforce. So main d'œuvre means workforce or manual labor. And the next expression, which is another one of my favorite, is enterrement de la vie de jeune fille. Enterrement de la vie de jeune fille. Alright, so when you see the word enterrement, of course you know enterrement means like a funeral. It sounds like a tragedy, but on the contrast, it's actually a joyful occasion. So enterrement de la vie de jeune fille does not mean the funeral of the life of the young woman or the young girl, but it actually means the party you have. So you're a lady, you're about to get married. That eve, the eve of the event when you get to meet your friends, when you get to have a party together and maybe bury your single life, is called enterrement de la vie de jeune fille. Okay, and for the groom's eve, the bachelor's eve, we call it the bachelor's eve, is enterrement de la vie de jeune garçon. Enterrement de la vie de jeune garçon. Okay, that means the bachelor's eve. Okay, so it's not a tragedy, but of course a joyous event. All right, so the next expression is poutre aux yeux. Poutre aux yeux. So you know, poutre means powder, the yeux means eyes. So this we want to think means the eye powder, but no, it does not mean eye powder. So eyeshadow in French is actually le fard à paupières. Le fard à paupières, that's eyeshadow. Okay, so poudre aux yeux does not mean eye powder. It's actually a political term that means to give someone a positive vibe, a positive gloss, sort of. Okay, that's what that expression is. Okay, poudre aux yeux, to give someone a positive gloss, kind of. And the final expression is pourboire. Pourboire. All right, so if you're learning French already, this shouldn't be difficult, because the word pour means for, while boire means to drink. So for a drink or for a drink. But the correct expression for this actually means a tip. Okay, so pourboire means tip. Okay, so you're at a bar, you're at a restaurant, you want to give the waiter or waitress a tip. You give the person et pour boire. Et voilà, c'est la fin de la vidéo. Si vous avez aimé, n'oubliez pas de vous abonner à la chaîne Rapide French et cliquez sur la cloche. Merci. Alright, so if you haven't already, make sure you hit the subscribe button and turn on the notifications so you will be notified anytime I upload new videos. Merci et à très bientôt.